Dania Jackson posted a crazy post about her divorce. Let's watch and discuss. Sister in Christ, fellow natural sister in Christ, the video you're making to show people that you're better than him in this divorce effort, we already know. You don't have to make it. You don't have to make those grade school clapback videos that we do when we're in the 8th and 9th grade and we're getting back at the boy who started dating a little girl down the street when he was just dating you. You don't have to make these videos online. Those are Blackistan games for Blackistan prizes. These are because he took you through mind games and like Blackistan stuff or Blackistan prizes. When you have confidence in yourself, you're like, okay, well, I can always get another man. You know? No trip. He don't treat me right. I think about in Texas, Rodney Reed. He is in jail because he was sleeping with an engaged white woman. The fiance, who is a white cop, found out, killed her, and accused the black guy of doing it. Now Rodney Reed is in jail. Stacy, the lady that was killed, his fiance, she knew he wasn't right. She had already started to move on with Rodney. I'm just giving you characteristics of what a lot of women, regardless of any race, but especially white women, know your worth. And, you know, the world has told us so much that we aren't worth it. But now you see so many black women that are naturalistas and quiet like yourself and me that are marrying men of other races that have similar values. They're marrying guys who are really pro-black and pro-black woman in particular. They're pro-black and pro-black woman at the same time, which is rare. They're marrying black guys like that as well. And you're a naturalista. He's a pretty boy with muscle shirts. I tend to see women that look like you have husbands that are non-black, like I say, or and are kind of the same, near the same size as them, not as big and just like gargantuan like the man you are divorcing. Like aesthetically, I would never pair the two of you together. You're talking about expanding your ministry. there's some Christian couples that have really good ministries, whether online or as co-pastors at a church or, you know, what have you. And, you know, you get vibes that they're best friends at home. You also get good vibes that they're, you also get vibes, even though they're not touching on each other in public, they're not hugging each other in public or on camera, you still get vibes that they're having a healthy sex life. Like, the way they stare at each other, even at church functions, like they can't get enough of each other. You could tell that they're best friends and they're probably having a healthy sex life. People look at those minute details. That's how you expand ministry as you know, that from the outside looking in as a fan, looking into married couples with successful ministries. People look at intricate details like that. Like, is she, not only is she dressing well for him, are they best friends? Do they feed off of each other? Do they have a natural vibe? Does he appreciate her? Does she know how to pick him? Does she understand the signs that he appreciates her? Do they look like they're probably bouncing off the walls, you know, in their bedroom when they get home? Like, are the vibes just like that strong? That's how you expand your biblical ministry. That's the secret from the outside looking in. But you don't have to do this. I pray for you. You know, it's hard. I pray for you. You will get through this. But you got to get some more self-confidence and stop doing this stuff for the cameras, because you're better than this. And there's going to be a man that comes along in due time where you don't have to do any of this to get his attention and to make yourself look like the winning woman in this formula. All you have to do is stand there in a large t-shirt and baggy shorts, and he's still turned on by you. You could be in a full suit, covered up, none of your curves showing, and he's turned on by the words you're saying and how you, you know, minister to people about God. You don't even, you know, in a genuine sense and not snapping at them. Like, when you truly decide to give your entire life to God and be yourself, like, it is going to be entirely different. Like I say, I would have never paired you with him until I found out who you were. I usually see women that look like you with short, non-black guys. Sometimes with, you know, skinny or short black guys. But like I say, they have to be pro-black woman. They can't be like most black guys that are pro-black and pro-black only. They have to be pro-black and with emphasis on the pro-black woman. If not, you're better off with a non-black man, because even though he can't understand your plight, he's working hard to please you. Whereas a lot of black men understand your plight, but are not working at all to please you. And the main point is for him to work hard to please you. So, sister in Christ, her friends, anybody going through a similar situation, if you should ever see this, know that I'm praying for you, and know that you are so much better than this. Pray to God that you understand who and what your dating market are. It only takes me 2 seconds to see that your husband likes fast women with weaves and wigs. And not every woman with weaves and wigs is fast. But yeah, you aren't, you never seem to be his type to me. But praying for you.